Right here. Just like that.
Are you scared?
Why is it Auntie Shantae's coming?
The smell.
It's a penis. Oh! Disgusting.
Hey y'all, Bill the Hall of Fame Collector here. And congratulations to Miguel Cabrera, 500 home runs. JT was thinking about you when he did that. Just happy he hit that milestone. 3,000 hits are next. Don't really think he's going to hit that this year, but early next year, probably, I would guess, is last year, next year, possibly. He should hit that milestone as well. This is going to be my last video until probably second week of September-ish. Just with the wedding going on, figured I had just a chance to get this one in here and then take a little hiatus. But the hits do not stop. The last video was absolutely absurd. So I appreciate all the views. I'm really thrilled to have what I have. In this video, I am going to show off a baseball autograph, a basketball Hall of Fame autograph, some Maddux and some Gwynn, of course. Topps, PWCC, Panini, Fanatics. You know, I've been watching all these videos, commenting where applicable, and really interesting. I'm actually excited. Maybe there's a chance Upper Deck can get back into baseball, maybe more competition. That's what I'm hoping for. I'm not hoping for dumping everybody and only having one brand. That's kind of what it's been for years and years and years, but I want multiple brands back in baseball and basketball. So let's do that. First things first here, this autograph, I was really contemplating selling this set. I'm probably six or seven away from completing the set for the Stars and Hall of Famers, but just never got around to. I probably would regret it if I did. So when this thing popped up, I jumped on it. And that is the 99 Epic Signatures, Century Epic Signatures, Johnny Bench. Super blue autograph, numbered, hand numbered to 100. The blue, super blue ink, fresh looking ink, sold me right away. Immediately clicked buy it now. Also, I must mention, that I probably should have waited to do my 500 home run collection video. Being Miggy was so close, I gotta figure out maybe how to add a clip into that video, but maybe 10 videos or so ago, I did a compilation of everything, all of the 500 home runs footage that I could find for each Hall of Famer or each individual in that club. So check that out if you haven't. I really enjoyed making that. On to the 90s. So, these cards are unfreaking believably tough. I'm talking about 1997 Pacific. What is this? Pacific Crown Collection? This card here is the parallel. It's really hard. There's two different parallels. There's the light blue and the silver. If you're a 90s collector, you know what I mean. I don't know if you can tell on camera, but this happens to be the light blue. But very often, and I think these were like one per pack or something, so very common, very easy to find. However, there's a silver version, and it is presumably has a print run of 67, which from 1997 is just super, super, super low. And it's just really, really hard, because here, this looks like silver. Really hard to actually capture silver. Many collectors go buy 5 or 10 cards before they actually get a silver. It's that hard. I actually went through 3 Maddoxes before I pretty much gave up and said, I'll never get this darn thing. And then sure enough, an opportunity hit, and I got a really good price for this thing. And that is the 97 Crown Collection Silver. Izquierdo. And this is a pretty good condition. They're not numbered. There's nothing that tells you that they're silver or not. But you just have to look at the foil, and you may not be able to tell in this video, but it is night and day in certain light that this is the light blue and that is the silver. So super tough, super, super tough. I tell you, the most important thing you can do as a collector is when you find somebody selling something that you want or need, you ask if he's got any, he or she has anything else, because that was the product of buying this. The 1997 Pacific Crown Collection Tony Gwynn Silver. Again, you get this up against a light blue, you can tell the difference. It is just super silvery. And again, print run 67 for 1997. So I go from thinking I'll never get one to having one of each of the players I'm collecting. Now back to Tony Gwynn here. Maddox does not have this card. And so this was a good grab at auction. I might as well just show it. What you're looking at here is a 1994 SP special effects. They had a insert called the Hollow View, which is it's kind of a landmark insert. It's the first insert to have this kind of like hollow foil where the player's face moves or whatever. And the Hollow View is typically a blue color, but then there's the special effects, which is this red color and it's die cut. So a lot of times they call this the SP Red. And these are much harder, 1 in 75 packs. And to just get one, let alone the player you want. And the print run, which is pretty low for the time, estimated to be around 700. We go from one kind of landmark insert to another landmark insert, and that is the first game-used jersey card for baseball. They were issued in 1997, Upper Deck, and they are called the Game Jerseys. This is a very interesting card. It actually is kind of multi-layers, which surprised me when it came in. There were only three players that were in this checklist from 1997. One of them was Griffey, which is a crazy expensive card. I don't know, four figures maybe now for one of these. Ray Ordonez, and then Tony Gwynn. So I'm happy that Tony Gwynn was in that landmark insert. Next, I take you to the year 1999 Upper Deck. This is an insert called View to a Thrill. And there's different parallels of this. I think there's one to 2000. There's just a non-die cut. But then there's this one, which is number to 100. And then there's also one with hollow foil. I think it's number to 10 or 101. I'm not sure. I think there's a 1 to 10. But View to a Thrill, Tony Gwynn. Back to Gregory Maddox and 1996 Leaf. 96 Leaf had parallels, bronze, silver, and gold for each card in its base card set. I managed to snag the checklist card in silver. So let's see the silver hollow foil. That's the silver. And these have a print run of 1,000. And then here's the base card, and this is the gold. Bronze and gold are pretty tough to distinguish, but when you have it in person in a light and you have them next to each other, you can easily tell this is the gold. And this gold prep proof has a print run of 500. And last, a Basketball Hall of Famer I did not have. This gentleman's name is Joe Brennan. Born in 1900, died in 1989. Class of 1975 as a player, 1919 to 1936 with Brooklyn, three-time Basketball League champion. He also coached college later in life. He was one of the best players of the 20s, known for his accurate shot with both hands. So he's pretty tough. Happy to get Joe Brennan. I think this puts me at 321 or 322, something like that. Different basketball Hall of Fame autographs.
What in here?